Well, around 10 years later, and it's half as good as the first, even if that doesn't count for anything really at all. The 1991 John Hess directed a requel that tells pretty much the same story as the first film, but with much less effect. The plot. 11 years after the events of the first movie and the baby alligator to the end of that film has grown up, I think it could be a totally different alligator for all I know. Detective David Hodges, played by Joseph Bologna, has quickly become aware of its existence with the help of his wife, Christine, played by Dee Wallace. Now with a partner, Rich Harmon, played by Woody Brown, and an expert alligator hunter, Hawk Hawkins, played by Richard Lynch, the trio set out to hunt for the beast. Meanwhile, the mayor is in cahoots with the slimy real estate boss, whose goons have been dumping toxic waste into the sewers. So instead of a clever idea where dogs filled with steroids are dumped into the sewer and the gator eats them, this time some bad guy just put barrels of toxic waste in plain sight in the frickin' sewer. That just shows how much heart was in this. Not much. I'll start off with the positives. This film was directed by John Hess, who also directed The Awesome Watchers and produced the infamous American History X. I can kind of see his staple on Alligator 2 when compared to Watchers. He definitely has a way with having fun with each scene. Even if a lot of the charm and humor didn't make it from the first to its sequel, I still feel this film isn't absolute shit. The actors and actresses all do serviceable jobs, but some dialogue is a bit cringeworthy, especially from Woody Brown. Vincent Brown, played by Steve Railsback, is a real slime bag. However, unlike the mayor from Jaws, there's nothing redeemable about Vinny. Joseph Bologna looks like he's for the most part having a blast. I like how there's this good cop who's friends with a lot of people in the streets and ghettos. It shows that he cares dearly for the city. Dee Wallace's character is wasted here. She's mainly there to spout exposition. It's a machine. It's a thing. She's giving way too much credit to an alligator. Don't even compare it to John Carpenter's The Thing, because it's not even close to a thing's level of special effects. Speaking of the effects, the gore, the effects. This was rated PG-13, which is odd because John Hess directed Watchers, which was an R-rated film, and this is a sequel to an R-rated movie. One would think it would carry the torch. I can only assume New Line Cinema, who handled the limited theatrical release, didn't want a very violent movie because the budget was double the first, coming in at a whopping $3 million. I can't really see where it went. You'd think it'd cost less than the first. Maybe the permits cost a bundle. I think this was filmed in New York, after all. Unfortunately, the effects are not up to the par in this installment, especially as compared to the first. It felt like they really held back. We don't even get a good look at the guitar until around half an hour in. Some shots of the animatronic head look okay, but other times it's just ridiculous. Especially during the carnival scene, where it chases a boatload of people, but only kills one during said chase. The motion picture soundtrack, it's okay. Kind of memorable, but nothing too great. The synth is kind of poor and really feels dated. More so than anything from the 80s. This was a 90s movie, after all. It is very underwhelming. With how awesome the first film is, I can't even say this is half as good. If they came up with an original story, then yeah, I'd give it a decent grade. This is below average. There are some good performances, but that is about it. Plus, this is a clear copy of Jaws, only it'd be a nuclear Jaws. Even as a kid, I didn't love this one. I knew it wasn't nearly as superb as the first, and that I always skipped over this one and went back to the first. I tried tracking down the elusive VHS tape for this film for years. Finally, I decided on this Blu-ray rip or whatever it is. It is not worth the money I spent on it, though. Overall, I give Alligator 2 The Mutation a 2 out of 5. Lion Brian Gatto, host of Horror Show Entertainment. Make sure to like my Facebook page in the description below and leave comments and subscribe.